Want to do a little update on my little grow out tank slash breeding colony. They're all doing pretty good. This one, I believe, is going to be the male. If I could get him to come out in the light, I did a water change, and about a half hour after that, he started showing some color. And now he's not gonna get in the light where I can see him. It's like they know when I'm filming and they won't cooperate. But the little Victorians are doing good growing up. That one's still the most colorful. He's got black bars. But I notice this guy's got the egg spots. I think he's gonna be the male. Originally, I thought the yellow one was going to be the male. It doesn't have any egg spots, but I don't know. They're all so young, it's really hard to tell. The Mbuna fry are doing all right. The gold barb fry, I am tempted to just dump them in with the South American cichlids and just let them get eaten, because they're slowly dying off. And there's that guy with the broken swim bladder. I can't believe he's still alive. But what keeps happening is every now and then in the morning, I'll come in and there's one stuck in that little overflow right there. And it's like they sat there all night, so it's usually dead. One of these guys was stuck after I got back from vacation. This guy was actually. And he still doesn't swim very well because of it, but he survived. I do still have this guy in here. If I can get him to come out. He's looking really good. Come on. Come out of there, dude. He doesn't want to cooperate either. They never do, it seems like. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. But, yeah. He's back there. Colorful as ever. But, yeah, this one has really surprised me. All of a sudden, that blaze on the fin showed up, and it had like a really orange shoulder. It's not showing up as much on the camera. But I thought it was really cool. All of a sudden, he started showing the color. And then I've got the 10-gallon. And this is it. The 10-gallon I put on the bathroom sink because I'm out of room, more or less. And these are the other Mbuna fry. They're growing up. Doing good. I think I've only lost two since I set this up. One morning, one was stuck in that little grate for the filter there. And then when I got back from vacation, there was one dead in the corner down here. But other than that, they're all doing really good. It's hard to see with the glare. And I stole the light off of this tank and put it on the other one so I could watch them more. But they're doing really good. I'm happy with this little colony. Once the ones on the hang-on back breeder box get a little bit bigger, I'm just gonna dump them in here with these guys. And I started doing 50% water changes every single day on this 10-gallon. Not that bad, because it's only 5 gallons of water a day. You know, do what I can to simulate them being in a bigger water column. You know, I would eventually like to find room and set up like a 55-gallon grow out. Move those guys in the other tank into a 55. Put these guys in that 20 long. You know, but eventually, we'll see. Another little project I've been doing with my girlfriend. She's got this vinyl cutter and stuff. So she's been doing all kinds of stuff. She made a bunch of signs. So I cut this piece of wood, routed the edges on it, stained it, and painted this arowana on it. Just a little project. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it. I'll probably just hang it here. I'll sell it if somebody wants it. I could make more of them. I don't know what I'd sell it for, 'cause I don't know what it's worth, honestly. Let me know what you think it's worth. If you'd buy something like this, let me know. But yeah, side projects, you know, gotta keep busy. I'll go to the 75 and I'll be right back. Here I am at the 75-gallon African tank. The water is still super cloudy, and I've just come to terms with it. I put water clarifier in there, let it run for a week. It didn't make any difference. This guy's still got his home dug out. She's holding again, and he's actually leaving everybody alone, as you can see. As long as they don't go under the rocks where he's dug out, all the sand under there, down to the glass in most of it, he dug out all of that. And as long as they stay above all that, he's for the most part kind of leaving everyone alone. She'll go down and hide down there with them, but usually she likes to come over here, and she dug out this little spot down here, or it's been dug out by one of them, but she's kind of claimed this little spot under that piece of driftwood. And she likes to just sit down there, kind of hide from everyone. This guy, I can't remember what he's called. Ever since I put in the sand, he's lightened up. He shows a little more pattern, looks really good. He's getting a little fat. The new pink one's doing good. All of his fins were grown back until yesterday. And then somebody nipped at his anal fin again. And it was finally looking really nice, but that's what happens when you own African cichlids. I have noticed my Taiwan reef kind of lightened up in color. And I realized a lot of people's Taiwan reefs have a red anal fin. And he barely has a little bit of yellow on his. I don't know if that has anything to do with maybe he's a female or. I don't know. Give me your thoughts on that. This OB is looking really good. His whole body is becoming reflective blue underneath those black specks, and his whole face has turned extremely reflective blue. He's looking really good. The dragon blood is looking good as always. Man, you can't see the colors on the camera near as well as you can in person, of course, but the Venestus is doing good. That crooked mouth he's got from the fight when he was really little, but my VC10's doing all right. The Eureka Red back there with it. The other two Eureka Reds are doing all right as well. I only have two of the Lemon Jakes left. One of them unfortunately passed away. But they're growing. They're starting to. The snapping turtle is lazy as always. Sits around. He's got three fish left. He had a dozen in there a week ago. And then the 80 gallon community tank. Yellow as always from all the tannins of that log. They're all fat and happy. The Bolivian rams down here. It's pretty fun to watch. The one, where's the other one? Can't find him. Oh, there he is. The one I nicknamed Nemo, because he's only got one fin. Roseline shark, fat as always. The electric blue acaras are doing good, growing up. Still some of my favorite fish. A lot of personality. They're a lot of fun. Firemouth cichlids are fat. I probably overfed a little bit this morning, but they'll be fine. Firemouths are fun. Normally, they're a lot more active and more aggressive. I think right now they're using a lot of energy trying to digest. Let me know your thoughts. Suggestions on cloudiness for that African cichlid tank would be appreciated, because I took out one of the media trays in a canister filter. I filled it with carbon. That didn't do anything. I was gonna do Purigen, but Amazon is famously lost another one of my packages. It was supposed to be here in December. That reminds me, I need to email them about that again. I want to try the Purigen. I've been told it's, you know, what everybody would do. I guess it'll work, but we'll see. My German blue ram is still doing good. The last one I bought died, so I'm never gonna, well, maybe not never, but I'm definitely not gonna buy another one anytime soon. This guy's been doing really good, but anytime I put another one in here, it gets ick, which then a couple other fish in the tank get ick, and it just becomes a whole thing. And I just don't even want to bother with it. Right now, everything in this tank is healthy and doing good, except for the one orange molly, which I do not see at the moment. But he's been sick for a long time. The killifish are always fun to watch. They stay active. I like the colors on their fins and whatnot. They're really interesting fish. I kind of want to get more killifish. I thought about just doing a small 20 gallon with just a bunch of killifish in it. Be kind of cool. Maybe a little planted tank. Oh, and the beta's still doing good in here. Let's see, if he's not in here, and I don't see him, then he's definitely in here. Let's see if I can move that out of the way. If I can get the thing to focus past the glass.
Where are you at, guy? I know he's down here somewhere. Come on, guy. Oh. Somewhere.
The beta's hiding.
He's always in the log.
In one of the holes. But anyway, I don't know where he's at right now. If there's not food floating around, he won't come out. But I think it's been a little bit since I did an update, so just thought I would post a quick little update video. Oh, I see the sick guy. He's hanging out in the back down there. I feel so bad for him. But I tried everything. He sat in a quarantine tank for weeks with heavily medicated. He had salt in the water. Everything you can do to help treat bacteria infections and fungal infections, and nothing seems to work for that guy. But he's still kicking. I did have another Dalmatian Molly in here, and it got sick and died within a week. But this guy just... I feel bad for him, because he looks horrible. But nothing will work to heal him. I just don't know what to do anymore. But I also don't want to spend a small fortune trying to save a $3 fish. You know? But when I come up with, or next time I change something, I'll probably post another video. I do have some stuff in the works. And I'm going to be starting a Facebook group and a new YouTube channel once I get the ball rolling on the on breeding and importing fish. I've got a lot of research to do. You know, if anybody knows, do I have to have any kind of licensing or what I need to do to sell fish? I would, you know, if I sell fish in any amount of quantity, I don't know if there's laws and stuff. I really gotta do some research. I gotta figure out what it takes to import fish from other countries and whatnot, and you know, make sure that I'm doing things legally. Last thing I want to do is try to start a business and end up getting in a lot of trouble with the law, you know. So if you have any information on that or know anything that could help me with that, please let me know. I would definitely appreciate it. My little girl, she gets scared. I think she's afraid I'm gonna capture her. Every time she has eggs, I get her and I pull her out for a few days. Poor girl is miserable. This time, she's going to... I'm not gonna touch it. She's gonna have those babies in this tank. She's gonna have to take care of them and raise them. And I'm just gonna see what happens. Hopefully she'll be able to keep them away from the filter intakes. But... Until next time. It's an update on my fish room.